that you love one another as I have loved you, that you love one another as I have loved you. By this shall all know that you are my disciples, if you have loved one for another. By this shall all know that you are my disciples, if you have loved one for another. I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you love one another as I have loved you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, we are on the fifth day of the octave of the Nativity of the Lord. Emmanuel, the presence of our Lord is with us. Let us ask the Lord for His grace that we may continue carrying His presence all throughout our lives. For the times we have not loved God as we should and not loved our neighbor as we should, let us ask God's pardon and forgiveness. We pause a moment in introspection. And so we say together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We glorify God in the words of the Gloria.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King. O God, Almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen, amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and invisible God, who dispersed the darkness of this world by the coming of your light, look, we pray, with serene countenance upon us, that we may acclaim with fitting praise the greatness of the nativity of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, by this we know that we have come to know Jesus Christ, if we keep his commandments. Whoever says, I know him, but does not keep his commandments is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoever keeps his word, in him truly the love of God is perfected. By this we may know that we are in him. Whoever says he abides in him ought to walk in the same way in which he walked. Beloved, I am writing you no new commandment, but an old commandment that you had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word that you have heard. At the same time, it is a new commandment that I am writing to you, which is true in him and in you. Because the darkness is passing away and the true light is already shining. Whoever says he is in the light and hates his brother is still in darkness. Whoever loves his brother abides in the light, and in him there is no cause for stumbling. But whoever hates his brother is in the darkness and walks in the darkness and does not know where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our response shall be, let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Kindly repeat, Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. O sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord all the earth. O sing to the Lord, bless his name. Response: Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Proclaim his salvation day by day. Tell among the nations his glory and his wonders among all the peoples. Response: Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. It was the Lord who made the heavens. In his presence are majesty and splendor, strength and honor in his holy place. Response: Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Let us prepare our hearts for the gospel.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing his praise, sing his praise, sing hallelujah to the Lord.
A light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing his praise, sing his praise, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the day came for them to be purified as laid down by the law of Moses, the parents of Jesus took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, observing what stands written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male must be consecrated to the Lord, and also to offer in sacrifice in accordance with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now in Jerusalem there was a man called Simeon. He was an upright and devout man. He looked forward to Israel's comforting with the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death until he set eyes on the Christ of the Lord. Prompted by the Spirit, he came to the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the law required, he took him into his arms and blessed God, and he said, "Now, Master, you can let your servant go in peace, just as you promised, because my eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared for all the nations to see, a light to enlighten the pagans and the glory of your people Israel." As the child's father and mother stood there wondering at the things that were being said about him, Simeon blessed God, blessed them, and said to Mary, his mother, "You see this child, he is destined for the fall and for the rising of many in Israel, destined to be a sign that is rejected, and a sword will pierce your own soul too, so that the secret thoughts of many may be laid bare." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
To the words of the gospel, may our sins be wiped away. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, I'm basing our reflection on the first reading that we have just heard. The Jewish way of knowing God and the Christian way of knowing God was almost the same. God could be known by revelation. To experience God meant that God had to reveal himself to us. It was not on some human speculation or by some exotic experience of God that we would know him. But to know God meant that God had to be revealed. And we see this in the mystery of the incarnation, which we have celebrated a few days ago. It is through the revelation of God that we have known God himself. God who is symbolized in love. To know God meant to experience him more deeply in love. And Christ is that symbol of love. It also speaks of the commandment which is old and also new. When John wrote, he spoke of the commandment that is old. He's saying, I'm not saying something new. I'm giving you the same old commandment, but still it is new. And new because it brought about a new dimension. And this new dimension, we see first from the Old Testament, Leviticus chapter 19, verse 18. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. This was known to all the hearers at the time of Jesus. They knew this commandment. They knew it was there. It was part of their law. But Jesus gave a new dimension to it. And what was new? A new meaning to it. And that new meaning, for example, Jesus loved them and he wanted all to love each other. And some things can be, though they are old, can be seen new. Like for example, a game may become new when we see an expert playing it or a champion playing it. Or a piece of music may become new to us when some great orchestra plays it under the baton of a good conductor. A dish of food can be a new experience when prepared by an expert cook. An old thing can become new when someone with the right touch handles it. In Jesus, love becomes new in two directions. In the Old Testament, or under the Jewish thinking, it was the sinner has to be destroyed. The sinner has no hope. In Jesus, the sinner who comes home is welcomed with great joy. God is seen as a loving father waiting for the sinner to and embracing the sinner who is lost and has come home, who has returned back to God. A sinner has hope. A sinner comes back. It's a new dimension of love. God welcomes the return of the sinner. In the old understanding, it wasn't there. A sinner had to be damned, to be destroyed. We see the great favorite verse in the Gospel of John, chapter 3, verse 16. God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whosoever believes in him will live forever. And therefore, when we see the beauty of the love of God, it also shows us the second direction which in Jesus' love. It says that this love has no limit, no condition. It goes to a long way off than we can expect it. Jesus could even pray for those who nailed him to the cross. That was the love. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing. Jesus could forgive even those who nailed him to the cross. And that shows that the love of God goes beyond all length. The commandment of love that was also understood as old, but given a new meaning in Jesus, a new standard. We are celebrating the season of love. We are celebrating the season of the Lord's presence. We are called to love one another, to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. We are called to love God and to love one another, which is the most difficult part is the second part, to love one another. We can always say it's easy to love God, but to love one another, to forgive one another is the most difficult. I remember most of us are familiar with Divine Retreat Center in Kerala. And in one of the talks, the director, Father, spoke to us about how they used to have the retreats and scores of people keep coming week after week. And then they had a revelation that they would also not preach retreats, but also be practical by reaching out in love. And they built homes for the sick, homes for the aged, homes for the dying destitute, homes for the mentally challenged, homes for the orphans. And in the same complex, they also had these people who were left, who had no one to look after. Anybody who would come to the doors of that retreat center was accepted. Those who had no one, no place, no shelter to go. And these homes, they would help them and bring God's love. It was not only preaching a retreat, but also to showing it in action in the love of God. And one of the sharing that Father shared with us was in the mentally challenged section. There were children there, and they were doing their morning prayer. And Father was taking a round in that very corridor, and he entered into that section. And one of the prayers of the child he heard, and the child said, "Loving Father, bless all those people who called me mad. Loving Father, bless all those people who called me mad." And then Father took this child's prayer for a reflection. And he's saying, this mentally challenged child has already learned to forgive and to love those who hurt him. And here we are preaching retreats to those who are in the proper frame of mind, preaching and trying our best to teach, to love and forgive. And it becomes so difficult. But a person who's not in the proper frame of mind yet knows that he ought to love and forgive. My dear brothers and sisters, the greatest challenge is to love God and to love one another. Both are equally important. Let us ask the Lord for help. It is only through His grace that we can really move on. He strengthens us where we are weak. And that grace only He can give us. If we deeply ask from within, with faith, "Lord, help me. I need you. I need you." And list out all those whom we ought to love and we are not loving. I'm sure God will give us that super strength from above to reach out in love. Then this passage becomes meaningful to us. We ask God's assistance. We pray in silence for a moment so that the Lord may minister to each one of us. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Please pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of His holy Church.
Amen. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in Him God made visible, we may be caught up through Him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At a time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We now turn around and share the peace of Christ. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that by the power of these holy mysteries, our life may be constantly sustained. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic and be available to all. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild
is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, late in time behold Him come, offspring of the favored one, veiled in flesh the Godhead see, healed incarnate deity, pleased as man with man to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heavenly Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness, light and life to all He brings, risen with healing in His wings. Mild He leaves His throne on high, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to God.